sorry, I'm late.
Oh, you're sorry. 2 hours.
Ew.
I just kissed your earring. Oh. Well, let's sit down and eat. No, I know. I just came from the gym, and I just found out that Bev, it's for sure, Bev Francis is going to compete in this contest.
Who?
In December, here.
Well, who's Bev Francis?
Oh, that's right. You guys don't know anything about her. She's this Australian powerlifter who has got to be the most muscular woman I have ever seen. I mean, she's 180 pounds now. I mean, the last time I saw any pictures of her. If she comes down to a really good competitive weight, then she'll just be outrageous. She's got muscularity that most men wish they had. And it's just something that the judges up until now have never seen. It's rumored that Rachel is supposed to win this contest, but I don't know. Is somebody like Bev around?
Are you worried?
No, because it's competition. I mean, it's well, a game.
So it's just somebody else to compete against, right?
Yeah. I'd really, at some point, I guess I would really like to look like Bev.
It's a challenge.
But on a different frame.
So many things in bodybuilding that everybody else is, you know, just discovering or just learning are instinctive for me because of synchronized swimming. They're so parallel.
Bodybuilding has always appealed because it's kind of, it's put those things together that I love.
Mm-hmm.
And, involving strength and because I love muscles. I just love muscularity.
I've always had them. I've always had to deal with, you know, kids. Even the guys on the gymnastics team would come to me and say, ooh, make a muscle, make a muscle.
Yeah.
The kids in the summer day camp would, oh, and there's muscle lady, yeah.
So, Carla, what do you honestly think of my chances in this?
Believe it or not, most of your male judges will go for the more muscular physique.
Yeah, I think so.
The female judges will be one way or another. If you're muscular and quote-unquote what they think is a feminine physique,
yeah,
then you have a very good chance. And they don't make a point of making a clear separation between sexuality and sensuality.
Yeah, that's right.
And many people just totally fail to make that differential between sensuality and what is so important anyway. I mean, if we are that shallow in our relationships to people, and if femininity only depends on having muscles or not having muscles, then what happens to the woman who, let's say, has to have a mastectomy? We've become so inured to the Playboy centerfold image,
yeah,
that it's really a slap in the face to women, because women come in all shapes and sizes and whatnot, and yet so few of our images are accepted. It's just this one narrow image that's accepted.
It's the commercial.
And it's not real.
Commercial image.
And it's not real.
Is Rachel's routine different, or it's just as voluptuous? I mean, she's appealing to the men, who just happen to be 95% of the judges. I saw that. That was my first time seeing her. I knew exactly who she was playing up to. Little Patty Lip.
I love you.
And to the richest women's bodybuilding contest of all time, the Caesars World Cup. The total prize money is $50,000. With a winner's share of $25,000. I might add, that is equivalent to the largest prize ever offered in any bodybuilding contest, either male or female. And that's a fairly good indication of how far women's bodybuilding has come in such a very short period of time. So if we're ready, let's meet the competitors. Oscar.
Now we shall bring them forward two or three at a time while the judges make their comparisons.
2, 7, 11, and 1, 3 of them.
Number 2, Tina Flackinger. Number 7, Rachel McCool. Number 11, Carla Dunlap. Double biceps, please. Side chest.
There's a big difference in body changes with those three, and they're different waistlines.
Thank you. Thank you.
Six, seven.
Mm-hmm.
The whole tour?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Number 6, Bev Francis. Number 7, Rachel McLean. Double biceps, please.
Yeah.
Side chest. Double biceps.
Total opposites.
Come on, Bev.
That's it. That's it. Hold it high.
High fives, baby.
Side biceps. Side biceps.
Tuesday, Bev.
Leg back, please, Rachel. No extra poses. Just the one I called.
Rachel's going to fight for this one.
Abdominals and legs.
Oh, you can bet on that.
Thank you. Thank you. Shelly Grove.
There's nobody next to her, Rachel.
Nobody.
Nobody.
God, it's just her and people next to her.
Rachel must feel like Napoleon did.
She's crying.
God, don't you love it?
Thank you.
Yeah.
No, she's sweating a lot.
Oh, gosh. Want some water? You just lying here. I'll get you some water. Rest for 4 minutes. That's only be down in about 5 minutes.
Get it, Lori. Show
him. Oh, so close.
Thank you.
I'd like to see Bev and Carla together, please.
Number six, Bev Francis, please. Number 11, Carla Dunlap.
New Jersey.
Back double visor.
Come on, Bev.
Take your time, honey.
Take your time and hit it hard.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
Come on.
Stand it out, Carla.
Hit the bottom. Hit the
card. Yeah.
Hit hard, Ben. It's there, baby. It's there.
Just take your time. They're getting some orange juice.
I'm fine.
You ready to go back?
Yeah.
Say she feels much better.
Abdominals and legs.
Bang! Come on!
Deep.
That's it!
Slow motion. Slow motion.
Yeah. Hey.
Thank you, ladies. That concludes the prejudging the first round. There will be a pause for a few moments while we examine the judges' mark sheets, and then we will begin our second round. Thank you, ladies.
Take your time. Don't miss that one. Good. One for me. Nice.
Drunk on stage. I thought, you know, Cherry Liqueur, high sugar.
You can use any alcohol. It should be white wine or like a bourbon or something. Never a high sugar stuff because it'll knock you out. You'll go...
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have the announcement of our 8 finalists. And for this, I have the pleasure of reintroducing Oscar State. Oscar?
Our first finalist, Tina Plackinger, USA. Chris Alexander, USA. Bev Francis, Australia. Rachel McClish, USA. Carla Dunlap, USA. Laurie Bowen, USA. Kaiyo Salin, Finland. Shelley Gruhl, USA. And now, three poses.
That's it. That's enough.
Thank you, ladies. Would you lead off to the left again, please? While once again the judges are recalculating the final score. There'll be an exhibition to cover the gap.
The judges, I'm told, are now coming down the stairs from seclusion. We'll have to take a look at them as they come out. They may look somewhat different than when they went into the judging room. And our eight finalists.
Up with the curtain. In our tradition, we start with the lowest place. We'll be receiving $400. And eighth place goes to Bev Francis, Australia.
Forget about this sport bodybuilding. What the hell are they looking for? Miss America?
It's a beauty contest.
In seventh place, Shelley Gruen. In sixth place, Mayo Selin, Finland. In fifth place, Chris Alexander, USA. In fourth place, receiving $4,000, Laurie Bowen, USA. And in third place goes to Rachel McLeish.
No! There's no way the girl is in third place.
$6,000 in cash, chips or check?
I'll take the envelope.
You took the envelope.
Not the cash.
Not the cash.
No. Rachel took the check. In second place, taking $10,000, either in cash, a check, or in chips. And in second place, Tina Plackenton. $25,000. Carla Dunlap, USA.
Carla, come take your money and your prizes.
And for Carla Dunlap, it's been the grand slam. The World Championship, Miss Olympia, and the Caesars World Cup.
I feel very numb right now.
You do? Can I borrow 1,000 from you?